as for the flag, we can go to our output cloth and pick one to start it with. Heavy denim is probably going to be closest. And then once we start off with these kind of base things, then we can add to them. So for here, my rope, I'm going to reduce the stretch resistance. I want it to stretch a little bit. And I think, and compression, I do want it to resist compression. For my flag, I don't want it to really stretch, and I do want it to resist compression. And I might make it, well, it's already, there's no rigidity there. Shear resistance, pin angle. Maybe that's fine, and I can always play around with it to see what it looks like. And then we hit play again. Because once I get the properties right, then I'll start adding some more stuff to make it look a little bit more dynamic. So the rope is starting to look a little bit kind of weird. And so we're here. There is something where you can kind of dictate bottom, but I'm probably going to have to increase its compression resistance. This is what I want to reduce, and there is a place, I guess I would have to go to compression resistance. Oh, that's right, I don't have to. I'm going to go to thickness and increase that. do want it to have thickness. And the other thing I'm going to do too is I'm going to move this out some, because there, this is going inside of here. And what I will do, select this. It's going inside it, which is the one thing I don't want it to do. Because what I want my flag to do is look like it's waving in the wind. And I might have to add some more constraints. Say I'm happy with where I'm starting from, and I missed it. Let's keep going.